Hello everyone, in this video we'll be looking at the lac operon. The operon is a segment of DNA containing the genes which encode proteins which are involved in the same biochemical pathway, or the proteins which are involved in a specific function in a particular cell. And all these genes are controlled by the same regulatory mechanism. Coming to the lac operon, the genes which are required for the lactose utilization as the energy source are arranged next to each other in the lac operon. The three genes which are involved in the lac operon are the lac Z, lac Y, lac A. Lac Z, which encodes for the protein called as the beta galactosidase, lac Y encodes for a protein called as the galactoside permease, and lac A, which encodes for a protein called as the thiogalactoside transacyclase. So these three enzymes will be useful for the lactose utilization at the bacterial cell. In the E. coli, we will be looking at the mechanism of how the regulation of these three genes will be taken care. And preceding to these three genes are the regulatory regions called as the operator region, where the repressor goes and binds, and the promoter region, where the RNA polymerase goes and binds and then starts the transcription process. And the other activator protein binding region, here it is called as the CAP, catabolite activator protein site, where the activator comes and then binds and enhances the transcription process. So coming to the structural features of the lac repressor, lac repressor is a tetrameric protein having four subunits, and these four subunits are involved in the binding of the lac repressor to the operator regions. And here if we observe, the operator regions are spanned as three regions in the E. coli lac operon. They are called as the O1, O2, O3. O1 is a strong operator region. Along with the O1, one more, either O2 or the O3 will be necessary for the binding of the repressor. Here it is in a tetrameric repressor protein. It is binding to the two regions of O1 and O2, or O1 or the O3 regions of the operator region. In the presence of the tetrameric lac repressor, the RNA polymerase will not be able to bind because the promoter region is not accessible for the RNA polymerase. And this repressor protein is being synthesized by a gene called as the LacI, which has its own promoter that is called as the LacPI, which will enable the RNA polymerase to bind and then transcribe the LacI. So this LacI, in the form of a tetrameric protein, will be able to go and bind to the operator region in absence of the low concentrations of the lactose. If the concentration of the lactose is high, which will be entered into the bacterial cell, E. coli cell, with the help of the limited number of the permease enzyme, which is on the membrane of the cell wall of the bacterium, and after entering into the cell, it will be acted upon by the beta galactosidase, which is present in the basal level, and beta galactosidase will convert the lactose into yellow lactose, where the yellow lactose acts as an inducer, goes and binds, changes the conformation of the repressor. So the repressor is no more able to bind onto the operator region. It will get detached from the operator region due to conformational change. Once the operator region is not bound by the repressor, enables the RNA polymerase to go and bind. Once the RNA polymerase is bound, the subsequent action, the next phenomenon is the transcription of the three genes lac Z, Y, A, which will be transcribed as in a single mRNA, later will be translated as the separate proteins, rather the enzymes. So what are the various conditions in which the lac operon will be under regulation? Here once again we can see how the lac Z, Y, A has given the single mRNA with the three initiator codons for the translation to happen from this mRNA, which leads to the beta galactosidase and the permease and the transacyclase. And here it is operator region, a region where the repressor binds, promoter, the region where the RNA polymerase binds, cap binding site where the catabolite activator protein comes and binds. And this is the lac I gene for the synthesis of the repressor. So in the condition of the low glucose and high lactose, usually the E. coli prefers the glucose as the primary carbon source. But if the glucose is not available in the growth medium and lactose is available, the condition is in such a way, low glucose leads to high levels of the cyclic AMP. Cyclic AMP goes and binds to the catabolite activator protein, enables the catabolite activator protein to go and bind to the CAP binding site, in turn stabilizes the binding of the RNA polymerase onto otherwise weak promoter of the lac operon. And here, once the RNA polymerase is stably bound, leads to a stable transcription of the LacZYA genes. And the genes are strongly expressed. Here, one thing what we understood in the previous slide is, when the lactose is available, it will be converted into LO lactose. That LO lactose will be going and binding onto the repressor and relieving the repressor from the operator region. And allowing the RNA polymerase to go and bind and transcribe all the genes. So the same thing here, you can see the RNA polymerase is now free to bind because the lactose is available. If the glucose is present in high concentration and the lactose is unavailable, the lactose operon should be put to off. How it is happening? High glucose leads to low cyclic AMP. In the absence of the cyclic AMP, catabolite activated protein is unable to bind to the activated region. Once the catabolite activated protein is not present, it cannot make stable binding of the RNA polymerase. At the same time, lactose is unavailable, so there is no availability of the yellow lactose to relieve the repressor from the operator region. So the repressor is stably bound to the operator region and there is no possibility for the RNA polymerase to go and bind, which comes under the negative regulation. And coming to the other, so lac genes are not expressed because there is no promoter region which is available for the RNA polymerase to go and bind. Coming to the next condition, where the glucose is present in low concentration as well lactose is unavailable. Low glucose leads to the high cyclic AMP. High cyclic AMP leads to the binding of the catabolite activator protein onto the activator region. But the condition here is lactose is unavailable. So no yellow lactose which is available, which will be made from the lactose. So low lactose cannot go and bind to the repressor. Repressor cannot be relieved from the operator region. So there is no place for the RNA polymerase to go and bind to this promoter region. Even though the activator protein is there to stabilize the RNA polymerase at the promoter region, the promoter region is not free. The reason is the repressor is occupying the promoter region. So under the condition of the low glucose and lactose unavailability, lac genes are not expressed because of the no ability for the RNA polymerase to go and bind. So the lac genes are not expressed. Coming to the other condition, under high glucose availability and lactose availability, both are available at very high concentration. But earlier we discussed that under high glucose availability, the bacterial cell prefers the consumption of the glucose only. That means the lac operon should be operative at very basal level. It should not be induced. So how it is happening? High glucose leads to low cyclic AMP. Once the cyclic AMP levels are very low, the CAP, catabolite activator protein, cannot come and bind. So this region is free. The promoter region is free and the lactose is available in very high concentration. So yellow lactose is also available. which relieves the repressor from the operator region. Since the operator region is not occupied with the repressor, the promoter region is free for the binding of the RNA polymerase. But here, the RNA polymerase cannot stably bind because the promoter of the lac operon is in a weak promoter. And here, there is no cap protein along with the cyclic AMP is present. So, there is no stable interaction. There is no stable binding of the RNA polymerase. And whatever the RNA polymerase which is binding at the promoter leads to a very low at the basal level of the gene expression. And cell uses the glucose at a very high rate and lac operon will be at very basal level. The expression of the lac operon is at very basal level. And coming to concept of how the signals will induce at the repressor the transcription of the lac operon. So, in presence of the glucose concentration leads to low cyclic AMP, binding of the catabolite activated protein doesn't happen, and imagine that the lactose is absent. If the lactose is absent, there is no release of the repressor. Repressor is still bound to the operator region. So, transcription doesn't happen. Under the conditions of the high glucose and the high lactose, there is a basal level of the transcription because high glucose leads to low cyclic AMP and low cyclic AMP leads to no binding of the catabolite activator protein. So, no stable binding. But since lactose is present, yellow lactose will be available, which relieves the repressor from the operator region. So, basal level of the transcription happens. The repressor doesn't bind because of the yellow lactose. Coming to the condition of the glucose absence, lactose absence, when there is no lactose present in the cell, there is no synthesis of yellow lactose, repressor will be still bound to the operator region. So, lac operon will not be triggered on. So, no transcription. In the case of the low glucose and high lactose is the preferred source in absence of the glucose. In absence of the glucose, high cyclic AMP and a high binding of the cap, and which in turn leads to the binding of stable binding of the RNA polymerase. Since lactose is present, yellow lactose will be synthesized, release the repressor from the operator. So, both are favorable. Repressor region is free. At the same time, RNA polymerase is stably bound. So, the rate of the enhancement of transcription may go up to the levels of the 10 to the power of 3. So, this is the scenario in conditions of either glucose is present or glucose is absent. Lactose is present or absent. How the transcription goes. It could be basal level or it could be no or it could be enhanced or induced transcription. Thank you.